Getting familiar with the sketch viewing tools is one of the best ways to improve your efficiency when sketching. In this video, I'll show you how to use these tools to navigate your sketch. First, when you open your sketch, you have the sketch workspace along with some other windows for estimate items. Because I am not working with line items in this video, I can hide those windows by holding Shift plus Enter. If you'd like to learn more about using those windows, check out the Xpert tip, Add and Remove Floor Covering Using Graphical Estimation. Next, let's go to the Sketch Viewing Tools. Sketch Viewing Tools are located in the Sketch Workspace next to the View menu. You can hover over these icons to see the name and shortcuts for each tool. These shortcuts help navigate your sketch more efficiently. The first tools I want to highlight are the view options. These include Plan, Elevation, and 3D. The default sketch view is the Plan view. It allows you to see the floor plan view in the sketch workspace. If you include a sketch as part of your estimate, you will most likely spend most of your time building your sketch in this view. The short key for Plan view is 1. Elevation view is a great tool to stack windows and doors. It allows you to view one selected wall surface. Elevation view is activated by clicking the elevation button and then clicking on the wall you want to view. The short key for elevation view is 2. The 3D view tool is a great option when writing estimates. 3D view can be used to see things like the height of walls and ceilings, the depth of stairs, and the shapes of roofs. The short key for 3D view is 3. If not already selected, while in 3D view, I would suggest clicking on the Outline View button. The short key for Outline View is Shift plus O. Outline View is best used when in 3D view to have a better look at things like a staircase. To close 3D view, click the Escape key and you'll be taken back to Plan view. To navigate your sketch, click the Pan Tool button. After clicking the Pan Tool button, your cursor will change into a hand icon. With the Pan tool activated, you can click and drag the hand as you move around your sketch. This is one of the most used short keys. You can also activate it by tapping on the space bar. Switching between different zoom tools helps you view the sketch from different perspectives. For example, the zoom out button reduces the size of the sketch on the workspace, making it possible to see more of the sketch. The short key for zoom out is the minus key. The zoom in button increases the size of the sketch on the workspace, which lets you view more details of your sketch. The short key for zoom in is the plus key. This is where the mouse wheel option comes in handy. Another way to zoom in and out of your sketch is to use the mouse wheel to scroll up and down. Point the mouse cursor at the portion of the sketch you want to zoom, then scroll. To have a closer look at your sketch without having to zoom in or out, click the Zoom to Extents button. The short key for this is Shift plus the minus key. This will display the entire sketch for the current level. Let's say you want a closer look at a specific door in a room. The Zoom to Selection button helps zoom in or out to the entire selected portion of the sketch. For example, to view this specific door, select the door, and then click Zoom to Selection, or use the short key, which is Shift and then the plus button. That's how you use sketch viewing tools to navigate your sketch in Xactimate. Fill out the survey below to let us know if there's anything you'd like to learn more about. And be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more Xpert tips each week.